Hello friends, welcome to our channel Piping Mantra. Other than that, some of the basic requirements are also need to fulfill while preparing the piping layout. Generally, instrument and electrical cable trays are placed above pipe so that if leakage happen, it will not damage cables at place where the cable trays are on either side of the pipeline. It is advised that hot pipes are as well as line carrying the flammable corrosive fluid are not placed in adjacent or near to the cables. On pipe rack, bigger diameter lines should route close to the column as far as possible, and smaller pipeline should in the middle portion of the pipe rack width. This should result in having less deflection of the pipe rack cross beam. On pipe rack having two or more tier, it is preferable to place all small dia line on one tier instead of distributing all in all tier. For all high temperature line running on the pipe rack, expansion loop should be considered so that it has to be route at the one end of the pipe rack. It is good practice to place all high temperature line adjacent to each other so that expansion loop are at one place for all the lines. When pipe is connected to two or more equipment in parallel arrangement of the piping should be similar as far as possible. This is to have same pressure drop in the system when standby equipment are operated. For all the saddle support equipment, one of the saddle is fixed and other one is sliding. It is recommended that after routing major line connected to such equipment, fixed saddle should be so selected that vessel expansion favorably act toward the absorption of the thermal expansion by connected pipelines. Do not look your own battery limit, but ensure that line continuing further from your battery limit or incoming line to your battery limit are properly represented by mesh lines on the other drawing also with coordinate and the elevation mark. For line which appear on two or more separate piping plan, it is advised that overall profile should be looked properly. Similarly, the choice of eccentric and concentric reducer should be made correctly. In order to simplify the situation, this is the normal recommendation. Like, concentric reducer is used in all the vertical legs. In some of the cases, we use concentric reducer in vertical wall as well. Similarly, for the eccentric reducer, it is used in all the horizontal leg with the flat side down, unless and until some additional requirement mentioned in the P&ID or from the process requirement. For all the pump suction line, we use flat side up reducer. As we know, this question normally asked in piping interviews as well. And for pump suction, which having the fluid, slurry fluid is used, we use the flat side down eccentric reducer. Similarly, for control valve, normally all the control valve we use flat side down. Depending upon the line profile, vent and drain are required mainly for two purposes. One is like process drain, which are mentioned in the P&ID. In that, we need to have show the valve. Another case is hydro testing drain and vent. In this case, we don't provide valve. Only coupling and plug is sufficient, and this hydro testing drain and vent also not shown in the P&ID. Okay, at the end we will take one example what should be this piping layout drawing contain. First of all, plan note should be there. It has to be marked or it has to be matched with the plan. Equipment shall indicated piping nozzle, instrument nozzle and other nozzle. All flange joint must be shown. Wall shall be indicated with proper symbol to indicate different type of like gate wall, ball wall, glove wall, butterfly wall, check wall with its handwheel direction. Requirement of the extant spindle wall which are below floor, we need to show its axis as well. Each line shall be designated with complete designation as per line list with the flow direction. Centerline elevation or top of elevation should be indicated for each line. All platform stairways ladder shall be indicated. Change of piping class should be clearly marked. It may happen that some of the equipment nozzle as well as instrument have flange rating higher than connected piping. All such places should be identified and marked clearly on the study piping plan. All online fittings, walls, instrument, connection etc. shall be indicated on plan. Tag number of the piping item, instrument item, process item shall be indicated as per P&ID diagram. Some of the special fitting which are not covered in piping specification shall be called out specially. Utility station as well as safety shower location should be shown. All lines should be completely dimensioned. All support point of the pipe to be indicated with correct symbol such as shoe, guide, anchor, primary support, and support coding shall be provided for secondary support for special support. All lines up to 6 inch shall be indicated in single line, and above that, like 8 inch and above, it should be double line. Also, battery limit, like we have already discussed, mesh line should be shown clearly. So guys, if you like our video, please like, share and comment. We are also preparing some of more videos. Let us know some of the improvement if required in comment section. Thank you.